Welcome back to Hello Nigeria. And yes, we already mentioned that we're going to be having a wonderful guest today. And he is a photographer, documentary filmmaker, and you know, one that is interested in urban development generally in Nigeria and Africa. I'm talking about no other person but Deji Akinpelu. Hello, Deji.
Hi. Thank
Welcome.
You. Thank you, look you for great. Having me here.
So, I actually, you know, saw one of your works and I got really excited to actually speak to you. Now, who is Deji?
Oh, well, Deji is a young guy who is trying to make as much possible positive impact that he can make in the society, exploring where he lives and trying to understand it and trying to make it a better place.
Okay. So actually, we're going to be talking about, you know, telling the Nigerian narrative through film and photography. And that's something you've been doing for how long, if I may ask?
For the past 4 to 5 years.
Okay. Yeah, why that choice of career?
Well, I've always had interest in filmmaking. At some point, I wanted to start off making films, but I couldn't. I was working and I picked up my camera and I just started taking pictures. Mm. But that picture started the interest, and it was quite intriguing for me, you know, photographing my environment and seeing the issues that are abound, the children that you get to photograph on the street, the movement of the people on the street, how people are hustling and all of that really caught my interest. Mm. And I decided to do a bit more research into what was going on as a photographer. So not just being a filmmaker as a photographer, but trying to understand the issues that surround what you see
okay.
around you.
Now, we in the media actually respect, you know, photographers and documentary filmmakers, but I want you to educate Nigerians today. Tell me about the power of photography and documentaries.
Well, there's a power. The power in photography and documentary is that it has the ability to change the way people perceive or understand a particular issue or circumstance. Mm. So in one imagery, you are able to change people's perception or understanding of a particular subject matter. So you take images of people, for instance, which I've done, people who have been forcefully evicted from their homes, and begin to explain the narrative behind that. Why were they evicted? Why are they being taken out? What should have been done? So it helps us to give the people who were never there the experience of being there. So it has happened. It happened 2 years ago. It happened 5 years ago. But we have this image and we have this documentary that is archived and is put there in history that people can always refer to and begin to say, okay, where do we start making the change?
Okay. What's your Instagram again?
Deji Akinpelu Photography.
Deji Akinpelu Photography. Now, when you tell this story, because I'm actually tempted to ask you, was this a childhood dream or it's something that you kind of just grew love for
I never held the camera while I was a child. But I was in an environment, I was born into a house where my father was a politician. So I had the feel of the people. I didn't have the feel of the camera as a tool. But I had the feel of the people who came into our house as early as 5 a.m., 6 a.m., who came to complain about extortion by government officials, people who had their children arrested by policemen unlawfully. People came into our house, and it was always about societal issues. So that was my first exposure in life. And I love the fact that my father respected people and he attended to people's needs. He was there for the people. He was someone who spoke for the people. Along in life, that was when I'm now able to pick up the camera that now connects me back to my upbringing of being able to tell the average person's story. So the camera has now become my own tool to make the change that I saw my father making in the lives of so many other people.
Now, when you tell this story, is it just a job for you, or do you actually see yourself having an attachment to these people? And, you know, it gives you more edge to, you know, put out there what you want to tell about them.
It's not just a job for me. I think, like, every other person who is out there today who is asking that, is this how we're just gonna keep going in this country? Is this how things will? So it is not the problem and the challenges we see around us is way, and the quest for us to solve it, I think is way beyond anybody's interest to meet their own daily needs. It's about the fact that we are here. How many of us is gonna run out of this country to Canada, to the UK? Who is gonna fix this nation? It's burdensome. It's how many years now since independence, and we look like a child, and it's worrisome. So it's about the desire and the passion to try and bring the necessary change to our community, to our society, to our nation.
Okay, tell me about two individuals or cases, you know, that you actually covered that really got to you emotionally.
Okay, I did a documentary called Kelechi's Quest, which is borders on the challenges of housing in Lagos. And that really, there's a popular Nollywood actor that we used.
Okay, so that's it on the screen.
Kelechi is a popular actor. So we wanted somebody that will represent young people and their challenges with housing in a city like Lagos. Mm. So he went around Lagos from trying to get a house in Banana Island, trying to get a house in a government housing estate, and to the slum area like Makoko. Mm. Decided to visit them, and you know, in the course of, he discovered that there were a lot of challenges for him to get a place to rent or own in the city, but he discovered that there are some people who even have it worse off. So he decided to make a trip to Makoko to meet with the people and understand their challenges. And it was a quite touching experience for him, trying to see how these people live under this condition, and particularly that they live under the threat of eviction. They are constantly being harassed by government officials that they're going to be moved away from there under so many reasons that are not really justifiable. So for me, as a documentary filmmaker, I'm bringing that issue to the forefront, particularly in this dispensation, in this era of an election, is something very dear to me and very important to me, because we now see it as a tool for us to engage the political class to say, what is your plan for housing, particularly for the urban poor? Because we have to change this narrative. We can't keep killing them. We can't keep chasing them out of their places. There has to be a plan by our politicians. And we're saying, now is the time for you to tell us what you are up to.
Oh, thank you so much, Deji. You made a lot of points with that one. So, last question. What do you have to say to any young and upcoming photographer and documentary filmmaker, somebody who wants to do what you're doing, if not more?
Keep at it. It is possible. All dreams are achievable. I think generally for young photographers, the first thing is usually, okay, I want to do something to make ends meet. So you probably find yourself doing events. For some people, doing events, but they really want to become a documentary photographer, but they rather want to do events just to make money. You can do that, but don't let go of your original dream. Hold on to it. It is very possible that you can get there. So just and keep doing your small little project as much as possible. So document things around you. You don't need to go very far. Try from somewhere. Try small. Somebody will discover you. Somebody will invest in you. And you can get to the big heights.
Okay, before you go, tell us about your recent projects. What are you working on right now?
So what we're working on, like I was trying to also talk about this, we are running a campaign called Don't Get Elected to Get Us Evicted. So it is a message from the slum areas of all across the city of Lagos. We are working with those who live in this informal settlement and informal workers to market women, mechanics who are constantly under the threat of eviction by government officials, saying the reason why we are electing you is not for you to fight the poor people of the state, but rather fight poverty.
Wow.
You understand? Ultra-modern markets are not. I've done a documentary work on markets in Lagos that have been demolished for several years. Sangros Market as an example, Jankara Market too, destroyed for many years, and the people who original occupants now trade on the street, and government officials go to that street to chase them off the street, whereas government has refused to develop the market. Mm-hmm. And ultra modern market is not the only kind of markets that we should have in our, we also need traditional markets.
Okay.
This is because as a photographer, I still want to be able to photograph traditional markets. Yes, make them more neater, more organized. Ultra-modern markets is not the only thing, you understand? For instance, you know, so that's what we're saying that we're trying to say with our work, that that we should look at the bigger picture. We should lend to our politicians to rather fight poverty and not the poor people that live in our society.
Okay, and there you have it, people. Fight poverty, and not to evict the poor people in society. Thank you so much for joining us, Deji.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.